practices, and this is the visualization. Visualization practice, the Vajrasattva practice with visualization. In the Vajrayana teaching, always said two practices, visualization and completion stage practices, or the dissolving stage practices. First we visualize, that means transforming everything, all the environment, including our body, in the environment of the Vajrasattva, pure mandala. Your body is Vajrasattva, yourself is Vajrasattva, and your perception and conception, all this in Vajrasattva status. So that's what we begin. And that is why we do this practice. According to the teaching of the Buddha and the Vajrayana teaching, reality level, the nature is already enlightened status. Everything is, all the five elements are the five female Buddhas, five aggregates are the five male Buddhas. There's nothing else beside the combination of the five elements and the five aggregates. So everything is the display of the divine mandalas. So really we're activating that realization without the burial or the hindrance of the dualities. That is the very power of the meditation of the Vajrayana. Immediately you are be in the Buddha status, not just awaiting Buddha long way in the future, you just become now Buddha. That is what the power of Vajrayana teaching is, in particular Inner Tantra. So we are the heart of the Inner Tantra, heart of the secret Vajrayana teaching, we visualizing and ourselves be that status. To become our that status, then always in the teaching said, be courageous one, be courageous, fearlessness. Don't interfere in your realization, meditation with intellectual ideas and skeptical hesitation, doubt. Those are the obstacles. It is undermining our quality of the nature of the meditation. Be in that status for a short time. We can do intellectual things and analyze all those things after meditation practice, before the meditation practice, but during the meditation practices, we start thinking this and that. That is then just a discursive thought and is a disturbance. So therefore, re-strengthening those courage and confidence. What we need, joy, devotion, confidence, and appreciations. How fortunate we are that we have such a great teaching of the lineage teaching of that we can really embrace and kind of reveal our nature. It's not just a coincidental, it's not just a seldom kind of happening by itself. Truly we are fortunate beings. That's what the Buddha said. To being as a human being is so special, so rare. We are human beings. Not just human beings, we have the 18 endowments, 10 luxurious qualities. And add freedom and 10 luxury qualities, we have that. And all this wonderful. And plus, not just that, and such a great teaching of the Buddha, Vajrayana teaching by Gurupema Sambhava, and all these great master of the Kama and the Therma teachings. Now really we can embracing that. This is all those great masters what we call, reaching enlightenment, become this great master because of doing these practices. It's not just they are born with the great masters. They practice, they meditate, they actualize with courage and commitment, confidence, joy and devotion and bodhicitta down to the earth. They really reach that realization. That's what we always appreciate. We are in that footsteps. We are following the same nectar they drink and the same path they follow and the same qualities. Same thing we have, and this is so special. So therefore, and then also so many beautiful other qualities in samsara that you all have. In samsara, every luxury qualities you have in this country, many. So it's not just coincidence. Both samsara level and the dharma level, we are very fortunate ones. Bring joy, appreciation. That's what we're going to also, by thinking of, bring out those qualities, we're going to remove our suffering, the difficulty, troubles, the challenges. We're going to transform that. And that's what also known as the bodhisattvas. Courageous ones for the enlightenment. Bodhisattva means Sanskrit. Courageous ones for the enlightenment. We're going to transform all the challenges, the difficulties, troubles on the way into the path so that it ignites our power, our courage, our commitment, our confidence, our destination, and our way advancing. Those are all important, that part of the practice. So again, back to these practices, we are the Vajrayana practicing, following that, in Vajrayana teaching, there's two practices, principal practice, visualization and the dissolving or the completion stage. This is the visualization. We're going to see ourselves as Vajrasattva, instantly appeared. And those old structures so clearly here. This is the one of the great masters teaching of the Nyingma schools, great Terdalungpa or the Mendolite. It's very powerful, it's so powerful practice. This teaching is practiced by so many Buddhist practitioners in Tibet, particularly in Nyingma. All Nyingma schools really they practice this. And then as well as Kagyu too, and many Sajas too. So this is very powerful practices, and we are really connected to that. So again, this is that your yoga, devotion, bodhicitta, and appreciation, those are the foundation of the Dharma, those are the central column of the Dharma, and those are the result of Dharma. We start that now. Now, so bring out the beautiful qualities, and then we follow that. It's just a, again, simple reminder again. As what the teaching said, Sangha is helping. Sangha means helping and support to each other. So we are all as Sangha members. So I'm just a reminder, kind of, I'm staying on this chair and kind of playing role of the as like ceremonial like that. So I'm just really reminding to you in a way, reminding to you and reminding to me too. So we all be in this beautiful status and bring up this beautiful attitude, as I said many times. Okay, thank you again. So now we follow these texts.